Church of God and Saints of Christ. To them that are sanctified in Christ Jesus. Called to be sent. To our esteemed bishop. To be grandfather Abraham. To the council, to the evangelists at large, the evangelists, to the elders of Israel, to the deacons, sister ministers, Church of God and Saints of Christ in general, I greet you by saying, all hail. Is it well with thee?
It is well.
I want to thank the Almighty God for allowing us to assemble here on this another assembly. I thank God for what my ears were able to hear thus far. I want to let you know before I go further that I believe every word I'm about to say. I do not preach what I don't believe. My Bible tells me he that cometh to God must first believe that he is. And that is a reward of them that diligently seek him. Every time I come before the Lord, I expect a blessing from the Lord. Jacob refused to let the angel leave without blessing him. My Bible tells me, blessed shall thou be when thou comest in. And blessed shall thou be when thou goest out. I don't believe in tearing down. I believe in building up. There is a time for everything under the sun. A day that shall be of thee shall build the old places. Thou shalt raise up the foundations of many generations. And thou shalt be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of path to dwell in. I hope that you will be blessed tonight. The joy of the Lord is my strength. I just have a feeling that somebody will be blessed tonight. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. So claim your blessing to me. As the Spirit gives me others, I would like to speak to you from one of the most popular scriptures in the Bible. It is one of the most read chapters in the Bible. These words were written about 2,500 years ago. These words can be found in the 40th chapter of the book of Isaiah. I'd like to read from the 5 and 20th verse through for the 1 and 30. It reads thus: to whom then shall he liken me? Or shall I be equal? Saith the Holy One, lift up your eyes on high, and behold who hath created these things, that bringeth out the host by number. He calleth them all by names, by the greatness of his might. For that he is strong in power, not one faileth. Why sayest thou, O Jacob, and speakest, O Israel, my way is hid from the Lord, and my judgment is passed over from my God? Hast thou not known? We have a tendency to forget. Our cognitive ability sometimes fails us. But tonight I want to remind you of these words: hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainted not, neither is weary? There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint. Somebody say power. And to them that hath no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they church makes me feel like an eagle. for a subject. God calls us to be like eagles. Can I say that again? God calls us to be like eagles. An eagle is a very wise bird. An eagle is a majestic bird. An eagle has the ability to rise above the storm. Come on, somebody. An eagle is known for its keen eyesight and its soaring ability. An eagle makes its nest in high and lofty places. An eagle has the ability to fly higher than any other bird. There was a story. Some of you may know this story about a farmer who went up into the mountain one day. While he was there, he came across a strange-looking egg. He picked up the egg and he placed it carefully in his bag. When he reached home, he put it beside some chicken eggs. And after a while, all the eggs hatched. And from that strange looking egg came a strange looking bird. The farmer didn't pay much attention to this bird. The bird grew and grew, and one day a stranger came to his house. And he saw the strange looking bird running around with the chickens. The stranger asked the farmer, "Sir, what are you doing with an eagle among the chickens?" The farmer said, "Well, this bird is a chicken. I raised it as a chicken. I fed it as a chicken. This bird is a chicken." The stranger said to him, "Well, if you will allow me, sir, I will prove to you that this bird is an eagle." So the stranger picked up the bird and held the bird high above his head and said, "God made you to fly high. God didn't create you to be among the chickens. I want you to fly and be where God wants you to be." And so he let go of the bird. And the bird started to fly. But when the farmer saw the bird started to fly, he reached for some corn and he threw it on the ground. When the eagle saw the corn, he threw it out of the corn and stayed right there. The farmer said, "That is to prove to you that this bird is a chicken." The stranger said, "Well, I'm still not convinced. I will come again sometime." He came back a few months later and he said, "Sir, if you would allow me, I will prove to you that this bird is an eagle." So what the stranger did this time, he took the eagle a little higher. And he said to the eagle, "God made you to fly high. I want you to fly and be where God wants you to be." And so he let go of the bird. And church, the bird began to fly. And guess what? What the bird needed was the wind beneath his wings. And he just keep flying and soaring. Sometimes, church, in our lives, we try to rise. But every time we try to rise, Satan put stumbling blocks in the way and we back up like a chicken. Sometimes we desire more in our lives. We desire a new car. We sometimes, church, we desire to end in church. Can I talk to you tonight?
Yes.
But somebody whispered in our ears. And guess what, church? We mess up like a chicken. But God wants us to be like eagles. Church, sometimes we fall. Sometimes we stumble. It's not how many times you fall. It's how many times you get back up. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his ways. Though he may fall, he should not be out of the cast down. All the odds shall fall to his right hand. God calls us to be like eagles.
Get loose.
Come on.
Get loose, God.
Listen to this tonight. I have found out that one of our biggest setbacks in life is fear. Come on, somebody. Fear is whispered in our ears and shouted in our faces. But God achieve meaning in your life when they are distracted or restricted by obstacles and setbacks and heartbreaks. I believe when people have limited resources, they find remarkable strength by looking within with persistent faith. They make the most of their sheer ability. Weakness sometimes are caused by limitations that are in our minds. We are plagued by doubts, lack of self-confidence, and worry. Come on, somebody. Church, don't let discouragement, indispondency rule your mind. Never ponder what you don't have or can't do. Leave behind self-pity and excuses. Say like David said, instead, think optimistic, hopeful, and constructive. See yourself as an exceptional person. Believe in your unique ability and do the best you can with your God-given gift. Church, we are not just ordinary people.
God is working the most.
So persevere, take the next step, expect what you desire, keep striving, and allow your faith to press you forward. Life is victory to those who exercise faith, hope, and courage. Step out of faith. Faith is what determines your future. Come on, somebody.
No.
I believe.